Welcome back, Khonius here. Today I'm flying from Las Vegas to Page, Arizona. I'm flying a Cessna Citation Longitude. Not sure my flight level, figure that out in flight. Reset the view. Go outside. Reset the view again. Take off the parking brake and let's get going. Flying over all the hotels and casinos. Alright, and we're on our way. So the approach is at over 6,000 feet. Maybe I'll set a flight level of 9,000. Turn on autopilot. Let it make some minor course corrections. Not sure what body of water that is over there. Admiring all the landscape here. It's beautiful. I do kind of wish I knew what water this was. Maybe it's a dam. think we're approaching the point where I should throttle back a little bit, maybe. Let's see. Planes should be able to go this fast, but looking at the total airspeed, that seems like it's exceeding specs. I know the ticker tape shows the red and white stripes, but in the cabin it won't say overspeed until you get above, I don't know, 480, 490. I feel like the game used to look better. It's still a little washed out. I've tried to increase the saturation a little bit, but I've just not been able to get it to have the rich look it used to have. I'm not sure what changed. I've tried various graphics settings. I think maybe it's just weather effects of being at this altitude. When you get closer to the ground, it starts to look like more like what I remember. So I attribute it to weather effects. But it would be nice to make it look a little nicer. Might be able to clean that up in Premiere Pro. Keep seeing the textures down there change. I'm contemplating at some point upgrading my Alienware. I have an Aurora R11. Maybe get the next generation Intel processors and like a 3090, RTX 3090 graphics card, something like that. But it's going to be a lot of money, so I'm not sure if I'd do that yet. I'd almost rather take that money and spend it building out my virtual cockpit at home. Oops. I have a couple of panels now. I've got a couple of Logitech panels. One is kind of a general switch panel with the landing gear and other things, lights, master, power to the plane. The other one is autopilot. Things like flaps and pitch trim. I would love to get their little dial controls so I could have the horizon indicator and altimeter and airspeed. Those are a little expensive. But at some point it would be nice to actually build out more of an actual looking airplane. Nice shots of all the scenery. See if my saved view is still there. Yep, there it is. I don't know if it memorizes the views per airplane or not. I've memorized them in a few different planes, but it seems to come back to working on this one. It's Alt and then one of the number keys to switch views, and I think it's Control Alt and one of the number keys to set it. I guess I could test that. I could make a right side view Control Alt 3 and then Alt 3. That worked. Don't know what the other numbers are set to. Yeah, I guess nothing. They've never been set, so they don't change it. We are going awfully fast. The plane seems to be happy with it. It seems to be within spec. It would be telling us over speed, I think, if we were going too fast, but I don't know if maybe the upper regions of the speed range are meant for special cases like descending or emergencies, so I'm not really sure about that. But it seems to be okay. Recently watched a video explaining what these three balls are when you're sitting in the cockpit. In fact, I'll move over to that view. You're supposed to line up these two balls, and if you line them up perfectly, then you know you have eyeball view on everything without having to turn your head or move. Oops, I didn't mean to. Let me switch back to. Let me do the default view. No, that one's always too close. Anyway, so those let you align your head so that you just have to look around without moving, and you can see everything you need to see. Maybe if I can find that video, I'll post a link. Seeing a lot of interesting stuff here on the ground. Not sure what those orange colored deposits are. So there's not always that much to do on a flight, as long as everything is going well. That's what I wanted. Okay. Oh, so interesting. My Alt 1 will toggle between previous view, I guess, and its current view. Let's see if number 2 toggles. I guess it toggles back and forth to the default view. makes sense. Easy way to get back. I just find this view to be a little bit too scrunched. I'd rather be able to see that Garmin panel the whole time. Switch to the drone, maybe take it out a little bit. Look at the grounds down here. So when I get out of the weather, the saturation builds and it looks a little bit more normal. So I do think those are weather effects I'm running into. I might be able to find a way to minimize that. Okay, I think I've gone a little bit ahead of the plane. I wonder if I can find my way back up to it. Oh, those, it's interesting, all this rusty stuff on the ground. Okay, now I'm probably back in line with the plane. Let's see how close I am here. I think I may have already passed it. There it is. Okay. Yeah, they really sped the drone up when you set it up to 100% speed. Again, there's all these rich colors on the ground. Look like iron deposits or something. Yeah, as they go higher, everything gets very blue. Just feel like this used to not be this way. And it doesn't really look that realistic. I don't think if you were in a plane at this altitude that things would look like this, so don't really know what to do about this situation. Anyway, reset the drone. Mostly looks okay at this altitude, 9,000 feet. Approaching the airport, so I'm going to begin dropping speed. Actually, let's switch back to the external view. I'm going to begin de-throttling. I feel like my frame rate ought to be higher than that. I'm on high settings, high-end settings, with no tweaks. I think I didn't tweak anything. Possibly I turned on lens flare. Sometimes that's off by default. I assume my 9,000 foot height is good enough, but the ground does seem to be coming up on us. Garmin shows that too. I just don't know if the airport is before that point or not, but we'll pull up if we need to. Perhaps we will be okay. We're 800 feet or so from the ground, so we have enough clearance. Wind seems nice and steady. I don't think we're going to hear the 500 announcement, because we won't get that close. I'm looking at the radar altitude here. Dropping the throttle just a little bit more, see if I can get down to around 250. Contact the airport, get the parking, or I mean a pattern entry set up for us. Okay, this is KPGA, so I must have missed it. Right there. Okay. Don't remember what runway I should be on, but it was north-south facing, so probably one of these.
Kilo Papa Golf Alpha traffic KA53131 miles southwest, 9,000 feet inbound to land runway 15.
Probably unmanned. That's actually kind of sexist, I guess. Unpersoned. I'm not sure what would be a better term. Unfacilitated or something. all these cracks in the land are really interesting. I guess fallout from the last ice age or something. Actually, it's probably much more ancient than that, now that I think about it. I am going to take over from autopilot and start heading towards the pattern entry. Climbing a little bit, that's okay. As I approach, I will slow us down a bit more. Would like to enter the pattern at something like 180, I guess, somewhere around that. Okay, I can probably afford to begin nosing down now a bit. Drop the throttle a bit as well. Alright, the training wheels are beginning to emerge. Like this is going to be an interesting one. It's difficult to tell yet where the actual entrance is. I think I see it. It's right where that pin is. Put down flaps, stage one, and push hard on the stick to keep from getting altitude. Like I said, I'd like to get to around 180 to enter. get there. We have plenty of time to slow down. Actually, looks like we're getting there now. Going a little fast, but that will change. Well, those evaporation ponds look really pretty. Give us some more thrust so we don't keep dropping in speed. Yeah, I'm still going a little slow for my taste. I'd like to stay above 160, but not too much above. Okay, I think when I make this turn, I will put the flaps down to stage 2. Landing gear down. Down. Flaps stage 2. A little sloppy, but got the job done. A little bit of throttle to compensate for the flaps. And I like to kind of hug the right side of the brackets. And as I make this turn, I'll put the flaps down all the way. Wide turn, but that's all right. I'm gonna recover from that. The flaps are going down all the way now. We're also descending faster, so might not need any throttle yet. Got the runway in sight. Our speed is fine. A little little on the slow side. Always have a little bit of trouble with micro corrections at the last minute, so I'm going to try to avoid that if I can. Okay, I think we're okay. We're going a little on the slow side, but this seems fine. Brakes on. I'm gonna try the spoilers. Did they go up? Yes, they went up. Oh, that's beautiful. Look at that. Now I can put the flaps up and get off the runway quickly. It's the first time I've used the spoilers, but I noticed the plane had them, and I thought that would be a really nice way to slow the plane down, and it worked beautifully. Okay, I'm running into trouble because I'm using the rudders on both the stick and with my feet, and it's confusing the game. So let's not do that, and let's park, which is that. I think I just need to announce clear of the runway or something. Yep.
Kilo Papa Golf Alpha Traffic KA531 is clear of the runway.
And then just make my way somewhere to park. There's nobody to tell me to stop and hold or any of that. I'm just going to park right here.
Kilo Papa Golf Alpha Traffic KA531 is clear of the runway. Kilo Papa Golf Alpha Traffic KA531 is clear of the runway.
Alright, the parking brake is on. Shut the engines down. So here we are in Page, Arizona. Never been here before. I've heard it's beautiful. It's kind of funny reading some reviews of this airport. People complained about following golf carts to the wrong parking area or something. Didn't really understand that, but mostly got some good reviews, especially the beautiful area. Okay, so the engines are off. Turn off the plane. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.